Well, in my opinion, I think they should be prosecuted because we are in a diplomatic country. Nigeria is a country that practices democracy. And looting is a very, very big offense, irrespective of the part of the world you come from. So Nigerians should not be exempted. My point here is they should be prosecuted for one reason, for others to learn.
Definitely, first of all, I would say nobody will want anybody who stole or a criminal to go scot-free. So everybody should be prosecuted for any criminal act. If you ask me or 1,000 people, they'll definitely give you the same answer as which I'm giving. So they should be prosecuted, of course.
Whomever that commits an offense should be prosecuted. First of all, they are meant to be forced to bring back the money. We need this money here to develop this country.
They are not going free. You need to collect the money from them. You lock them up in jail so that they will realize that what they are doing is not good.
Arrest that person. At least you need to let us know who that person is. Do you understand? At least you... That's... Do I say publicity? We have to know that person. Because if you keep on arresting them and you're not showing them to us, you just collect the money. And I don't think if they're collecting, they collect all the money. The ones planning to steal more will continue stealing and it will keep on going on.
There's some people that need the money that they will use it for their own beneficiary, like the poor widows. But them, they will use it as their own personal money. Now escape while it's not their own.
Well, basically, I think looking, you have to take into consideration the peculiarity of our environment. And when you talk about prosecution of corrupt public officials, first question that comes to mind is, do we have a competent judicial system to take care of them? The prisons, in what state are they? Are they corrective facilities? Of course, all these things don't work. We all know it. So basically, I'm thinking, it might sound drastic, but I'm of the opinion that some problems require drastic solutions. And you take examples from some Asian countries where punitive measures are taken against corrupt officials, like long jail terms. If it has to come down to giving them the death sentence, so be it.
Who are responsible for what they did, which is not correct? Because the corruption in Nigeria is too much. Make the poor to become the poorest, which means there's money in this country. But the people at the top, they're holding the whole money. So they should ask for reforms and even jail them.
No, that is what we masses are saying, that they should return back to the country. Okay, return it back to Nigeria and then put it where people could benefit. Like opportunity for job is not there. Education, people are in some other places like other states, they don't have a very good good atmosphere for their learning. And so we want that money to come back to Nigeria, okay?
If you check the level of corruption, you see that if care is not taken, it's so humongous that it could bring down a nation to its knees. So I think we should go the whole length in punishing this kind of people.
Because if they're let to go scot-free, a lot of persons are still going to... We have young men who are coming up into politics. And Nigerian politics is becoming an avenue for which people want to make fund and they don't want to lead. There's a difference between being a politician and being a leader. So many persons we have in Nigeria want to become politicians because they want to loot. So I think they should be prosecuted, sent to jail, so that others who are coming up will learn good lessons.